Nje kuvuga amagambo make.
I'm going to speak few words.
Simenye iminota bampaye ariko nje kuvuga amagambo make.
I don't know how many minutes I got, but I'm going to speak few words.
Nje kuvuga amagambo make ariko meza.
And these words are good words.
Nasengeraga Sydney.
I was praying for Sydney.
Nari Melbourne.
I was in Melbourne. I felt someone in the spirit telling me this. And there was a covering over Sydney.
It
is a spiritual force that has to be uprooted from the spiritual realm if the churches or ministries have to rise up in Sydney. And I felt like for it to be removed, the people who are in Sydney, the inner man has to be born again. I'm talking about the inner man, the spirit within us. There is what we see, our physical body. There is this Tarasis that you're seeing. There is Tarasis who is sacred, who is a mystery, who lives within me. The person who is within me that you can't know unless the Holy Spirit reveals that person to you. So, when I tell you who I am, the devil is a liar. He can leave you with everything on top, and he may attack the inner man within you. Let me try to explain to you who the inner man is. If we ask blessing, whose hand is this? I'll say it's mine. It's mine.
Amaso.
My eyes. Those are my eyes.
Inda.
The stomach is mine.
Amaguru.
The legs are mine. I'll say that. And if you ask me, you the owner of all those things, where are you?
It means
that the person within us is the owner of everything that I'm putting on right now. When the inner man is sick, everything else gets sick. The inner man or your spirit within you, if it is crushed or sick, the whole body is sick. If your inner man doesn't see, your future is in jeopardy. It is not clear. If your inner man cannot see the direction you're taking, even when people clap hands for you, even when people praise you that you're very powerful, God is calling the church to look deep within themselves, to look in the inner man. There is one thing that the Holy Spirit has explained to me. Let me speak a prophetic word, because the Holy Spirit has been telling me something, and may the owner of this word receive it. That there is no way the Holy Spirit will sit in us. If us in our inner beings are not able to speak the truth to one another. You ask your neighbor, do you tell your neighbor the truth? We receive the Lord called Christ. The Bible tells us that Jesus Christ is the way, the truth, and the life. Every time you don't speak the truth,
Kristo abari hirya yawe.
Christ is on your side. He's not within you.
Mwuka wera arashaka mitima y'abantu ahantu yakwica.
God, the Holy Spirit is looking for hearts where he can sit and settle.
Ariko imbere mu mitima y'abantu.
But many times deep inside the hearts of men,
hari uburyarya bukomeye
cyane. There is a lot of hypocrisy.
Najyaga ntinya kuvuga amagambo akomeye cyane.
I used to fear to speak these words boldly.
Ariko narangiza naba nayavuze narangiza mu mwanya wanjye bagamva umwuka w'Imana aramcira urubanza.
But whenever I would withhold speaking boldly these words, whenever I would be on my own secret time of prayer, the Holy Spirit would convict me for not speaking out.
Mumuntu wacu w'imbere niyo nzu y'umwuka wera.
Our inner man is the house of the Holy Spirit.
Mumuntu wacu w'imbere.
In the inner man,
niho Imana ikorera buri kintu cyacu.
That's where God works everything within us.
Mumuntu wacu w'imbere iyo handuye.
Even when our inner man is dirty or unclean.
Nubwo Imana wayivuga ku munwa.
Even when you speak with your mouth words about God.
Imbere uba uri empty.
In the inside you're empty because your inner man is unclean.
Itorero irahamagarwa.
The church is being called
kongera gutunganya imbere.
For us to clean up inside.
Kongera kwemera.
So that we believe and accept.
Umusaraba ukagera imbere mu mitima.
That cross to enter into our inner man.
My God. Yes, ahimbazwe cyane.
Praise the Lord.
Hari ikibazo.
There is a question.
Problems.
Oh, there is a problem, yes. This message challenged me so much. I was fighting not to preach this message. There is a field that I've been praying from. I continue to fight the message. And then I heard a voice telling me, you're trying to fear people instead of fearing me. I feel like I'm someone who is on needles.
But
I'm
going to go
to the Holy Spirit and I'll speak what he has told me to speak. The Holy Spirit is not in the church because our inner man is not in the truth. People are lying to one another in church. People meet together with words. And the hearts are all on separate ways. There is no way the Holy Spirit will come and sit down there. Much as we tell the people who are not yet saved to
repent.
There is the repentance that the Holy Spirit of God wants from us who have already believed.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Ask your neighbor, how is your inner man? Mutima muyonjo.
Twahamagawe kwambura umuntu umwe.
We were called to undress one of our bodies.
Undi muntu mushya.
And we are dressed in a new body.
Twahamagariwe kugira ngo twambure tarasisi wa kera.
We are called to be undressing the old blessing.
Nambare ijambo rivuga ngo umuntu yari mu Kristo ahinduka icyaremwe gishya.
The Bible says that when we are in Christ, we are a new creation.
Hagarisha.
It's not just a word. That is real life.
Kwiyambura.
It is undressing.
Ishobora gukuramo byose.
It means removing everything.
Umuntu wiyambura ugira icyubahiro.
There is no one who undresses themselves and they stay respectable. There is nowhere a naked person comes here and you respect him. Any person who is naked, they will never come here and you clap for them. But being undressed means you have to undress the old man so that you can and dress up the new man. Before you put on something new, you have to accept to be embarrassed in front of people. A cross does not make you happy. It is not a joy. There is no one who accepts to carry their cross and they are rejoicing with it. When the Catholics failed to receive the cross within them, they made a cross out of a stick. We have to address so many things.
Power, preach. Somebody what? What?
We need Christ more than all these other words that we hear. We need Christ. Colossians chapter 3.
8 to 10.
8 to 10.
Hallelujah.
Amen. No one will dress you unless you first undress. Tell your friend that your clothes are waiting for you, but you refuse to be embarrassed so that you can dress. 8 to 10. Colossians chapter 3, verse 8 to 10. It says, but now you must rid yourself of all such things as these. Anger, rage, malice, slander, and filthy language from your lips. Do not lie to each other, since you have taken off your old self with its practices and have put on a new self, which is being renewed in the knowledge in the image of its creator.
Kuko mugomba kwiyambura umuntu wa kera.
Because you have to undress the old man. Christians are still quarreling. Christians are still lying to each other.
Hallelujah.
Amen. People, somebody lies to you, facing you, and laughs you completely. The Africans living here, you live and lie to each other face to face.
Yes, I am bad,
praise the Lord Jesus. Because we do not want to put off the old self. The old person is still working within us. The word saying putting off means nobody is going to address you. You're the one who will open the buttons yourself. You're the one going to remove whatever you have known.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
And the only person to dress you is Christ himself. The Bible is telling us to undress the old self. Let me tell you something that happened to me. I met the pastor, and I will not mention his name. And I was looking for someone. I asked the pastor, is that person existing, the one I'm looking for? I had a spirit of God tell me he's lying to you. And this pastor told me, that person left and went abroad. And then I heard a voice of God tell me he is lying to you. And because I had the telephone of the person I'm looking for, I had a voice tell, call that person. I called this person. And he answered. I said, welcome back from abroad. And then this one said, where did I go? I've been here all along. Who told you that I left? I didn't tell him the person. And then I said, if I tell him, he's going to be even more embarrassed. The Church of God that is in Australia, We received Jesus so that we can be a house. A house for the Holy Spirit. But for us to be the house of the Holy Spirit, we have to undress.
Yes,
we have to
undress.
There is no one who puts off the old self and looks
bad.
Whoever undresses looks bad.
Yes,
amen. What are the things that we are supposed to put off? Anger. Hypocrisy. God has been revealing to
me
that people are so hypocritical in Sydney. Amen. Have you seen someone? I'm not here to judge you, but I'm trying to deliver what I heard. Have you seen the people that you sit together with and chat? And then the moment you separate, they say, "We talked about it, but I didn't understand it so well, but I didn't get it." Do you know what that means? Do you know what that means?
That's amagambo.
They just talked and they met with words. But because their hearts are not yet undressed, or they have not put off an old self, the Lord wants our inner man. I don't know who I'm talking to, but the Lord wants our inner man. The Holy Spirit is moving around for where he can settle. He's looking for where to settle.
Open the book of Ephesians.
Ephesians.
Chapter 4.
The Holy Spirit wants to sit within us. Somebody told me that your messages are very painful. But much as it is painful, it heals the hearts.
Yes, I am.
Praise the Lord.
Okay, I'm sorry. Ephesians chapter 2, verse 21.
Chapter 2, verse 21, and it says,
let us start 19.
Start on 19.
To 22, yes.
22. Mm-hmm. Consequently, you are no longer foreigners and aliens, mm-hmm. but fellow citizens with God's people and members of God's household, mm-hmm. built on the foundation of the apostles and the prophets, mm-hmm. with Christ Jesus himself as the chief cornerstone. Mm-hmm. In him, the whole building is joined together.
In him, just to go slow.
In him, the whole building is joined together and rises to become a holy temple in the Lord. And in him, you two are being built together to become a dwelling in which God lives by his Spirit.
In him, in our inner man, in Christ. Okay. Muri Kristo Yesu.
In him.
Turubakwa.
We are built together.
Inzu yose muri Kristo iteranyijwe neza.
In Christ Jesus, when the whole building is put together.
Ndasaba abantu nk'ababiri mwabasore mwe nimuze babiri mwe muzi.
You're welcome, brothers, your volunteers.
Point muru kwisi idutuma tuba Christian.
The main point that makes us a Christian, before even you go out to preach, is that you should be a house for the Holy Spirit.
Hallelujah.
Amen. We are the house or the building for the Holy Spirit.
Hallelujah.
In Christ. We all know how a house is built. It is just joined together. They put one brick to another. It's all built together with so many things. In Christ Jesus,
You're
also built together.
Amen.
Amen.
Turubako.
We are built.
Why? Kugira ngo tube urusengero rw'umwuka we.
So that we can be a building for the Holy Spirit.
Sundi mwuka.
There is no other
that
spirit.
Holy Spirit.
But the Holy Spirit to be living in us.
Mwuka.
Not any other spirit.
So mwuka wa kutongana.
Not the spirit of quarreling. Not the spirit of doubt. Not the spirit of
hypocrisy.
Not the spirit of lies.
But
the house of the Holy Spirit. Because the Holy Spirit is the one who tells us about God. He explains everything more about God. Ask your neighbor, how do you feel inside your inner man? God is calling us to put off the old man. All the things that do not glorify God. Praise the Lord so much. For us to put on the new man, there is something that is in the church. You preach and people get excited.
But conviction. Hallelujah.
But conviction. Very few people now have conviction in the church.
Excited.
People have excitement in the church. But the conviction to allow the Holy Spirit so that they surrender to Him.
That's actually a pastor. It was fire. It was but conviction.
And people will be saying, we welcome the pastor. He preached. It was fire. But what about the conviction in your spirit?
So,
let me show you the prayer that you can
pray.
I am finishing with this Psalm chapter
51.
Let's see how this man prayed. Let me tell you one thing. I got born again in 1994. But in the last 3 years, I used to see other people's sins. But in the last 3 years, whenever I pray, I am seeing the sins of my
sins.
I no longer see people's sins. I realize how I'm a sinner.
Amen.
Amen. Because the Holy Spirit convicts me. Amen. I want to change every single day. Psalms chapter 51, verse
6.
This is the prayer of a man.
Hallelujah.
Amen. I'm reading from verse 6 to verse 10, and it says, surely you desire truth in the inner parts. You teach me wisdom. You teach me wisdom in the innermost place.
7.
Cleanse me with hyssop and I will be clean. Wash me and I will be whiter than snow. Let me hear joy and gladness. Let the bones you have crushed rejoice. Hide your face from my sins and blot out all my iniquity.
10.
Create in me a pure heart, O God, and renew a steadfast spirit within me. Let me ask you one question. How many of us are here and you know your weakness? And you know that in your spiritual life there are some things that you are struggling with. This is the prayer that for us to pray.
Create.
Hallelujah.
Create. And you. Oh, you need Daudi.
This is David saying, create in me.
mwarimuziko icyaha muri twebwe ari ari ibanga.
Do you know that sin in us is a secret?
Yes.
One day God revealed to me. God revealed to me how I had jealousy. And he revealed to me something that I didn't know. One time I gave a car to someone. I gave it out as a gift. Right now I don't have a car. I bought a car and God told me to give it out. And then God told me, I'll give you another car. Up to now, I've not yet received another car. But the person took the other
one.
And now, and yet, for me, I thought I was a generous person. But let me tell you how God showed me that I had jealousy. I was on a prayer mountain that exists in Uganda, and then I got a dream and I prayed. There was a girl. She was working for someone and she asked for her salary, and the boss didn't have the salary, and the boss decided to give her a car instead of the salary. Where I was sleeping, I was looking at myself as a generous person, and I was praising myself that I am somebody who listens to God's voice and does what God tells me to do. And the boss gets the car and gives it to this other girl. In the dream, I got up.
Hallelujah.
And the other boss was my friend. Do we have another car to use? And I was asking this man in the dream. And I asked the girl, do you have money for fuel for that car? And the girl picked the man and showed me, I have the money. And when I woke up, the voice told me, that is how you look like. You're still struggling with jealous.
What? Are we together? Create in me this initial
desire. It is a prayer to put off. After realizing there is nothing you have that you can hold on. We don't see. This is David speaking. He had committed adultery. He didn't even know how he started to fall into that sin. He's walking on the balcony of his palace. And then he sees Uriah's wife. And he loved her. The man within him had not yet died. The old man of David had not yet died.
Yes, I am bad.
Praise the Lord.
Be out of anointing.
What I'm telling you is out of the anointing. I'm not talking about the anointing.
Personal life.
I'm talking about your personal life. I am not talking about the king or the money or the... I'm talking about your real life within you. David looked at Uriah's wife. But because the inner man had not yet died, ask your neighbor, what is that within you that has not yet died and is still shaking? Who was here and you know you don't get annoyed, you don't get angry? If you find somebody who doesn't get, and if I pour this water on this person's head, the old man doesn't show itself unless you're having a challenge you're going through. Where you know that you have a problem, you as a person, is when you are challenged. The old man just rises up like that. You start lying without even planning to lie.
Let's
raise the hands and say, create in me.
It is not so kumwa, just create it means kurema.
It means to create just afresh. It's not just getting a new one, but God to create a new heart. And I heard a voice tell me, Tarsis, you're jealous. I woke up and cried. And then God, even the car I gave out and I started walking on foot. Praise the Lord. We are the house of the Holy Spirit. God is calling the church to surrender again. To ask God to create a new heart. To put off the old man.
Hallelujah.
Amen. And He creates a new heart within us. The Holy Spirit. And then He starts working through our lives. God bless you, everybody. Let's.